Hello and welcome to this academy. My name is Frederik and I'm a product designer here at Veo. And today we'll be walking through a very exciting feature called Player Moments, something that I've been very fortunate to help Veo build out. I'm very excited about that. All right, let's pick a recent match that we played and open it up in our Veo editor. So here we go. We have a match here. And today, let's say that we want to assess player number 8's performance. So as you might notice below the video here, we have a row of number that represents the player moments and all the players. They have been added to this row. And we have number 8 here, which is our left back. So we can quickly click number 8. And let's pause for a moment here. So, as you noticed, on the right-hand side, the panel moved out, which is essentially a list of all the moments that we detected for player number 8. Up here, in the top of the video, you can easily navigate between the moments. So go to previous or next. You can see that there is a total of 67 moments. On the radar view here, you can see that we have highlighted number 8 with a green dot here. So he is playing over here. If we continue playing the video, we can see that he will receive it right there. It's a little bit of playing it back and forth. We'll go to the next one. It does that automatically, so I can just sit back and rewatch it. So he's on the ball now, defending. Let's go to the next one. And he might receive it. We know that because we detected that, and so on and so forth. So I also have other opportunities to navigate number 8's player moments. For instance, I can use this indicator down here, which is a representation of where Veo actually detected that he was close to the action. So let's jump to this moment here. As far as I remember, this is a fairly critical moment of the match. So let's see here, he's going into a tackle and yeah, I remember. Unfortunately, this resulted in a goal for the other team. So this might be interesting for me as a coach to give individual feedback to player number 8. So then I can quickly navigate to the panel on the right side and I have this quick access to create a clip. So if I click that one, it opens up a clip create. It's already tagged moment, own team, and it also highlighted Alexander here. I can write a comment with my feedback. I can change the visibility. Maybe it's only for him. Maybe it's for the full team to see as well. And then I go ahead and create a clip. And now we have the clip created. If I navigate back to Alexander's player moments playlist, you can see here that you can share a link to this full list. Maybe I might be interested in sharing the whole list and then tell Alexander to go through them and maybe create his own clips for improvement. So since Alexander is part of the team, I can share this link with him. It can only be viewed by team members, obviously. I could go ahead and do that. Furthermore, if I want a little bit more control over what is generated in the playlist, I can do so by clicking the settings wheel here, and then I can toy around with like how much distance to the ball would I like to see, number 8 being, time on the ball, and then also how much time before and after do we represent each player moment having. Then I can apply those settings. I don't want to change right now, but you could. So if we close Alexander's moments for a moment, you might have noticed down here that some have a face on, some is simply just a number, some is labeled with their positioning. If we want to influence that and have our players represented down there, we'd have to go to the lineup feature here. So if you're happy with the formation, you can actually add the players to the starting lineup, or you can add them as substitutes down here. So for instance, this is just an example, I would go ahead. We have our left midfielder here. That's Rachel. And she's playing number 10. And then we add the player. And down here, Rachel is now represented as player number 10. From the same lineup feature, you can actually also assign who was the captain. So let's go ahead and say, in this instance, it was Alexander. So now Alexander got a captaincy label. You can also assign who the team selected as player of the match. Let's say that's also Alexander. So now he's labeled both as player of the match and captain. If you also have the analytics package and you are very good at maintaining who got the captaincy time over time, who is player of the match, match over match, you will actually, from the player stats overview, be able to see who has the most captaincies and who has the most player of the match. And that happens in the analytics studio. So essentially, that's it. That's the lineup feature and player moments. And remember, you don't have to go through the lineup feature and adding all the players in order for player moments to work. You can simply click player number 8, and then you'll still get that list of player number 8's player moments for you to give individual coaching and feedback. I hope that this will help you spend less time on sitting tirelessly and scrubbing through the video, finding all these moments. And then actually spending more time giving individual feedback to each and every player.